first and foremost say to all of you that have come down here. I just want to express to you that it's about doing the right thing.
I'm tired of looking back to the glory of generous motives. I'm tired of looking back to what it used to be like when Genesee Towers was up and going. I want to say that we can have a great flip, a great future. But here's the thing, y'all. It can't be bound by downtown. See, there's a flip called the North Side. There's a flip called the East Side. There's a flip called the South Side. And unlike some cities, Flint don't got no West Side.
On May 3rd, 2012, I was arrested at Flint City Hall. I engaged in nonviolent disobedience. I was not asked to leave the building. I was not warned to cease from speaking. I was not asked to place my hands behind my back. I was not informed that I was under arrest. I was not read my Miranda rights. I did not resist arrest. I was approached and slammed to the cement floor. Handcuffs were placed on my wrists so tight that my hands became numb and swollen. My arms were so restricted that my shoulders began to sting with excruciating pain. One officer placed his knee in full weight on the small of my back. Another officer placed his hands around my neck to keep my face to the cement. The weight was so heavy, I could barely breathe. Mr. Brown, my nonviolent protest did not warrant this kind of treatment.
What's good? What's your man King Mondo? Out here at the City Hall. Got to fight for what's right.
But we will stand up today. Is not the end of our movement. It is the beginning of our movement. And when we fight, we win. We never lost a battle that we fought. We never won a battle unless we fought. Somebody ought to have some authority and say, it is fighting time.
We sat by and allowed our elected officials to get caught up in gridlock. We sat by and never educated ourselves on the nuances of government and funding. We sat by and allowed apathy to run rapid through our community. We sat by and allowed the governor to come in and give us a city, give this city an emergency manager, not for the first time, but the second time. So I guess before we begin to discuss the idea of standing up, we better repent by getting down.
Our voting rights have been taken away from us. The Ombudsman's office was reaffirmed in the last election by the citizens of Flint. The last that I heard, we still have a constitution and our rights do count. So everybody who's here, I would hope that you would stand up because there's going to be further litigation. I call for the Justice Department to do an investigation regarding the civil rights violation of not only Dr. Flynn, but the voting rights of the citizens of the city of Flint. Our rights are being violated, taken from us without the checks and balances that our society, that our state, that our government was made upon. Our ancestors, my ancestors, fought for this country not to have our democracy taken from us. We go over to war in Iraq and spend billions of dollars for their allegedly getting their democracy, but our democracy here in Michigan is being taken away from us right before our very eyes.
When there's been a non-movement on the city's administration side to secure the safety for the citizens, for them to say that we'll be left with three stations in the city of Flint with 54 firefighters is inexcusable. Right. Inexcusable. We cannot operate like that.
Our message is not only for the city, but it's for the nation, that when a city man's extremity becomes God's opportunity. Hey. Working this city make a difference in the name of Jesus. Revival has started here. We leave back, and when we come back again, we will not just come back. Pastor Flynn went to jail by himself, but when he came back with a whole lot more. When we leave here today, we won't come back by ourselves, but we'll come back with a whole lot more. It is in the name and authority of Jesus that we leave this place, but we let every power that is not of God know that your power shall prevail and that you will reign. May God arise and his enemies be scattered. It is in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for this day, for this is the day that you have made. We will rejoice and we will be glad in it, because you have not abandoned us.
All of God's people, you're going to hear from us again. Stay tuned to WFLT 1420 on Saturdays, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. You'll get directions from us at that time. Remember, the video clip is on YouTube. The video clip is on YouTube.